Hi guys, it's Vlasak Vidya here again. And today I have once after the longer time time to do a lot of dishes. Well, it's 7:15 in the morning and I have to go to the dentist at about 10. So I have 3 hours to do some cycle now, and today we will do a shorter kind of an intensive cycle. It's actually intensive without multi-tap. Okay. So sadly you can see I am left with a quite huge pile of dishes. This is the dishwasher. This is my dishwasher. Model number I don't know, but register left its sticker on the door. A lovely register left its sticker on the door. Let's see what's in there. Right. Anyway, we have the fully loaded upper basket. In the upper basket we have many of different mugs, glasses, bowls, just a small plate which is not quite a bit in there, so I will put in the bottom. We have some mugs, glasses, some bowls, actually quite a lot of bowls, some larger kitchen utensil which you can see, one lay across there, second lay across there. This is good. And in the lower basket we have, you can see actually, we have, what do we have in the lower basket? We have some pots and pans, quite a bit there. So we have some pots and pans, quite a lot of plates, sort of topware, and sort of silverware. So I'm gonna do the intensive cycle with no multi-tap, so that's mean I'm just gonna add some quite a bit more things in the lower basket, which I have actually displayed. Just certainly goes like, should be like that. Should be like that, because was too much clothes to stick in. I have my half liter glass, which is actually with still left a drink in it, but I must doing some little bit other way, because there's a bit problem with must put these back, this top pad. Extend the glassware this side like that. Put the topware. Certainly have one more plate. It's actually going to stick in like this. And there is may a space for one more mug, actually. Nope, there isn't. So actually, I think, sort that out. And there is space for this. Side of the here. And yes. So I haven't managed to get quite a bit of everything in. So I'm left with the actually three mugs and one bowl. But anyway, I will put one a professional liquid up there. There's one professional liquid up. Anyway, now can stand the camera a little bit up. I will stand the camera a little bit up. Okay. Now then, of course, I will put this chair back. So, anyway, the upper basket is full loaded. The lower is too full loaded. Now check the spray arm. Check that they're not sticking up. Before I will turn on the dishwasher, I must, as you may know, always remember that the dishwasher has the turn on inside of the door. Anyway, I'm left with one glass, two mugs, one glass, two mugs, one bowl. Because I need to do at least quicker bit, I do use an intensive with No options. Let's go. Charge my camera, so I think this should have done a complete cycle. Well, we'll see. The dishwasher is now going to its pre-wash. Now, sometimes when the dishes are very dirty, the dishwasher does split the pre-wash into the two parts. So, and as that will sound quite a bit of minutes, 2 hours 5, usually it's about 2 hours 1, so now I think it will be 2 pre-washes. Little bit before half past 7, so it will be done at a little bit after half past 10. Now the dishwasher will have to topping up quite a few times. Well, after a couple of minutes, the dishwasher, now the dishwasher, you can hear, did split the part, split the pre-wash in two parts, and now going to, into the second part of Hidden, second part of Brainwash. Oh, this is the first time. I think this is the first time in the history which I'm recording when the dishwasher split the pre-wash into the two parts. Now we have the second hidden segment of pre-wash with quite exactly 2 hours. And it's 7:30, so the dishwasher will be done at 9:30 actually, which is really great. Now that's how should the dishwasher sounds like, and should sounds like that. All you can hear is really the jet spraying and the flowing water and the top popping now. And you can see turn the spray out. You can hear how the spray outs are turned. It's look. That's how the spray arms rotating and do its work. But if you can hear, there is not this case, but if you can hear in the dishwasher the bang, 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 there is something, then it's something not right. You might didn't check out the spray arms as I did. This is the reason why I can't hear the heavy banging. But if you can hear the heavy banging, you might didn't check the spray arms in the dishwasher, or and something is mine. So this, something mine the spray arms. So you have to do one thing. You have to stop the dishwasher. You have to stop the dishwasher when it's drained after its first pre-wash or after the pre-wash. You have to recheck the dishes. If it's something mine to the spray out, reorganize the dishes and then restart the cycle. But good prevention when you have not to do this is check the spray arm before you starting a wash, and if you can see there is, for example, the stuck topware or some stuck of kitchen utensil, and the spray arm shouldn't turn clearly and properly, you have to reorganize the dishes, unload something, put something out, and leave it for another load, or I don't know what, but you have to reorganize the dishes now. Okay, Now I will leave you to watch this beautiful action. On my dishwasher. And I'll be back when it's drying after the second pre-wash. here is the drain after the second pre-wash. What the dish is. Standing. And now it's filling into the main wash. We have 1 hour 45. So 5 minutes first pre-wash. Second pre-wash was about water an hour. You can hear quite a bit of recirculation pump. In a minute we will my stutter popping, but in a minute we will hear the how the tablet will rust. Cause in a minute should be open the box with the tablet, and the tablet straight into the main wash. Now I will tell you, sometimes when you have quite a bit tall stained glassware, it's better to fit it in the lower basket than to fit it in the upper basket, because then you shouldn't fit. If you have on one side the tall standing glass there, you can't put inside the tablet rusting. And now goes the tablet straight into the main wash. Now I will tell you, sometimes when you have quite a bit stains, it's quite a bit tall stained glassware, it's better to put it in the lower basket. When you have flat the wax down, turn the wax down, it's better to fit tall stained glassware in the lower basket, as I did my half liter bait. And because if you will stand the tall standing glassware in the upper basket, you can't put just the kitchen utensils, because if you have some larger kitchen utensils, for example some knives, you can lay across.
Now the dishwasher done gets main wash. Now I go back approximately 20 to 30 minutes to commenting the main wash. Okay, it's 8 o'clock, and the dishwasher is certainly in the main wash. When the dishwasher is in the main wash, the level of the noise is much more lower because the soot starting to grow up. So really, as the soot starting to grow up and the dishwasher is starting to heat, the level of the noise is much more lower. I'm going to clean my teeth with a pre-wash because I'm going to the dentist.
Okay.
So we should have about 1 hour 15 left. So they cleaned my teeth in the fact. 1 hour 15. So in the fact I did clean my teeth 10 minutes. Which is very well. Now I double cleaned my teeth with a brain wash because I'm going to the dentist today. It's the dental hygiene, so not really the classic dentist, but it's the dental hygiene that's me really standard dentist. But I'll maybe film the way to the dentist. I will see how much more I can film with my camera than this cycle course. Well, I did the shorter cycle without option multi-tap, because I'm assuming I have never done it without option multi-tap, and it did never split the pre-wash into the two parts. Okay, now the dishwasher should have nearly top of the heating now. She was nice, propane intensive. Now, in 1 hour 12 there is no more drain. But this drain, when it select the multi-tap option, which it hasn't now selected, so there should be drain at about, when it will be about 50 minutes here, not 1 hour 12. Because in the fact, the option multi-tap extends the cycle about to go about half hour longer. So really, there should be a drain when it will be 1 hour 50. When it will be 50 minutes only. Not 1 hour 12. So we'll see. In about 10 minutes, I will back with my comment to comment the drain after my wash. Thank you. Now the main was just changing a little bit. Still may not test. 1 out of 3. And we should hear nice and intensive main wash with the reticulation pump. So gas machine is now at the top of the heating. And you can hear how it's nicely washing. That's the final pause of the main wash. The main wash is nearly at finish, and this is the time when the recirculation pump has recirculated the suits in the both baskets, and washing is very intensive. Every time you can hear the this is the recirculation pump which helps the dishwasher to wash really intensive. A fast 8, there isn't exactly 1 hour. Thank you.
Okay, that's the finish of the main wash here. And on the timer is 48 minutes. See, it's draining a lot of soot. Should go to 1 minute down, 47, and now it's starting to its first rinse. Now I'm not sure if it's doing 2 or 3 rinses, where sometimes do 2 and sometimes do 3. Now you can see strange devils and all the temperature changing. It's like the shock for the dishwasher. Like for all, I mean like for all of the machines, it's shock when it's for example at the wash machine is the shock, like when you washing at 90. And when it's draining from the cool down from the main wash, and then when the cold water in the first rinse is like same in the dishwasher, when the cold water at the first rinse suddenly hit the door, it's like temperature shock for the glass. So now we are in the first rinse. Now I'm assuming you're doing only 2. Thank you.
Well, it's the end of its first round, and I guess there will be one more hot round. Took a bit of water. Yeah, jump about 2 minutes up. Not necessarily mean. It's the final. Yeah, the final hot rings. We just take our insight. Now, if you select the option multi-tap, it's not only extended about a half an hour a cycle, but two, it does not. Them does not take the standard amount of salt and rinsate, and when you're washing the heavily soiled pots and pans, as I have three in the lower basket, you will see there are three pans close to each other, but not too close. Yeah, there are three small pans, and when you're washing the heavy so pots and pans and plates, it's better when it's let it take the standard amount of salt and rinsate. If you're washing only lightly so items like a piece of the like our piece of the items which are sorted out because it was too full. Like there's the matzah glasses. Yeah, and I can see the, and I can hear the S, how it was open, the draw with the rinsate. And now let's take the standard amount of rinsate. Okay, I will back in approximately 10 to 20 minutes to comment the drain before the dry. Moreover, the second rinse is quite longer.
Thank you. Okay, it's the end of final rinse, and as you can see, the final rinse, there two for the moment turn the recirculation pump on. Okay, jump to the 18 minutes, and now, because I didn't turn on the option multi-tap, it'll be a short drying cycle. Now, I supposed it to be an emergency drain in about, well, it will be about 14 minutes. So in about 4 minutes, I suppose to be an emergency drain. Maybe in 2 minutes, we'll see. Stream from the inside. Yes. Okay, what's left? Just about 9 minutes, okay. Now we will see maybe in the 4 minutes an emergency drain and fill. That's not, sometimes it does happen, sometimes it not doesn't happen. Really, I don't know if we will signal this. Mostly it happens when it's, for example, too much soot log or too high temperature, the door blast. So it mostly happened when it's this occasion. So it mostly happened when it's this occasion when, well, there's an emergency fill and drain. Now I know maybe the drain process is boring, there's nothing to see, nothing to hear, only the timing and time on it, something or other, but never mind. I like to do complete cycles, really complete. We'll maybe see. Mostly it happens when it's, as I said, when it's too high temperature of the glass or when it's too much to lock. So, or if there is some dirt in the filter, I don't know what it does, but it's the emergency fill and drain. By the way, I will take a minute. I have new glasses on my nose. At the moment are in the case still because I did clean my eyes and did, well, because I did the hygiene of the teeth and clean my eyes, so my glasses are still in the box. fridge freezer, sorry. I think we can see in a minute the emergency fill and ready. Or if we won't see, no, we won't see, I think. Because really, there will be no more final drain. Because really, it started at 4 minutes sometimes, and now it's 3. So. So I think, or at least I hope, there will be a normal final drain. We won't see an emergency final drain. Fine. I didn't even expect it would run so short by so short time. Anyway, one final minute. There will be the final drain and then 0-0, but I will leave the camera left till the display will turn itself off. Because well, without it, yeah. Okay, it's the end, 0-0-0. Now after the short period of time, the display is showing 0-0-0 and all the dishwasher will turn itself off. It's the way how to save the money and energy. There is a way of overriding it, but I don't want to do that. I don't know why you want to do that. Thank you. Okay, so the dishwasher has now finished its cycle. So we just now open it up. To the fresh air. Can you? And yeah. So there's the end of the cycle. The dishes are clean. Some dirt is still waiting to go. Go in the next load. So yeah. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. And bye bye.